Hello and welcome back. In this episode, we're talking about the traditional cuisine of Afghanistan. And our guest, Shamsia, will tell us about the staple dishes of her country. What's your national cuisine like?
The most popular dish in Afghanistan is Kabuli Palau, which is rice, raisin, and carrots and lamb shanks. These are the main four ingredients, and obviously spices. It is served in every wedding, parties, gatherings. Actually, we have a very diverse dishes. We have vegetarian ones, we have meat dishes, we have a lot of rice dishes. We Afghans eat a lot of rice and naan bread. If these two things are not on every Afghan table, then consider like there is nothing on the table at all.
But these are very simple basic ingredients, and there is a special magic to make them taste differently in every single dish.
Yeah, the way we cook rices is different. So when you add the ingredient like raisins and carrots and the meat together, it gives a whole new different flavor to the rice. It makes it sweeter. We have the most spicy rice biryani, and then we have very sweet rice, which is Kabuli Palau, and we have the normal rice. We have a lot of rice dishes. Each of them has a very unique taste. I would definitely recommend if you are not vegetarian. Even if you are vegetarian, we have plenty of vegetarian food. You're more than welcome to give it a try.
You cook traditional dishes at home.
Yeah.
Are there any unique and special ingredients that are hard to find in where you live now?
To be honest, where we're living now, not really. Particularly in the area of Melbourne that we're living, it's very, very diverse. In fact, we have more Afghan ingredients in here than we have it in Afghanistan. Yeah, better supplies and the quality. Obviously, they import like the good qualities overseas. So no, I would say we have a very good variety of spices and ingredients for whatever we need. Majority of the Afghan families have their own tandoor where they can bake the naan bread. We have one as well. So we never buy bread or naan bread from the shop, because it's mum who usually bakes it, and it's the most delicious bread. Where we're living now, I think we're pretty lucky that we have access to a lot of things. And we have families who live in other countries. When they see our food, the things that we create, they're like, how do you guys have that? In a country like Australia, how do you have it? Like those family members, they live in Western countries. And I would say there is no place like Melbourne.
Could you give me three words that would perfectly describe your national cuisine?
Rich, aromatic, and colorful.
Thanks a lot for these insights. I'm sure everyone is hungry now. I will see you again in the next video.